What's up, guys? Drew Duncan here, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm coming to you from the banks of the sometimes beautiful Ohio River here in Evansville, Indiana. I say sometimes beautiful because sometimes this river tends to look green, brownish, nasty color. Looks okay today, but anyways, that's not what we're here to discuss. If you're familiar with my channel, you may notice that I post some content about music and theme parks and thrill rides, hint to my channel name, Top Thrill Duncan, but that is not why we're here today. Today I'm going to be talking about Evansville. I'm a resident here in downtown Evansville. I live right over here at the McCurdy. It is a historic building here in downtown Evansville. Wanted to take you guys on a journey here, kind of show you guys what it's like to be a resident here in downtown Evansville. This video is to encourage those who may be thinking about moving down here to possibly move down here, or maybe if you're thinking about moving to the Evansville area, maybe downtown could be an option for you. But I'm here to show you guys, you know, different things that there is to do down here, different restaurants, activities, shops, whatever it may be. I'm your guy for the day, and let's go ahead and go on this journey. This is the Evansville Visitors Center. Any information that you may need to know, this is the place to go. It's just on the riverfront, right off to the side of downtown. Here we are at the Evansville Museum. This is our city museum. We have another exhibit over here that has a train model that you can go walk through. I haven't been to this museum in quite some time. This whole entrance area is relatively new. It's haven't been here since they added this whole part to the museum. The entrance actually used to be right around the corner, but this is a pretty popular museum here in Evansville. We also have a children's museum here. Yeah, like I said, this museum seems to be pretty popular, and should be some cool exhibits on the inside, so you should check it out. Now, one of the cool things about the Ohio River is it's a hub for a lot of transportation as far as goods and things go. So you'll tend to see a lot of barges, like the one behind me, that tend to go through this area. And there's also one back over here. So you'll a lot of times tend to see barges coming up and down the river on a daily basis. As I previously mentioned earlier, this is where I call home. This is the McCurdy here in downtown Evansville. The McCurdy is made up of multiple apartment units available for rent. They have 1 and 2 bedroom units. Besides the McCurdy, there is many other different complexes here in downtown Evansville, and they keep adding new complexes, it seems like, all the time. So you have a definitely have a wide variety of options here in the downtown area as far as living goes. Right here behind me, like most other cities do, this is our main street here in downtown Evansville. It's very easy to find because it is lined with red bricks, as you can see. Main street consists of many different shops, restaurants, coffee shops, you know, whatever it may be. So it's definitely a fun place to come and hang out, especially at nighttime. We'll be right back. I think one of the things that Evansville lacks downtown that most bigger cities typically have is a lot of fast food options. But here's one of them. We have a local Jimmy John's here downtown. Another thing that I think they also need more of down here is local grocery slash convenient type stores. And this one right up here straight ahead is one that I like to visit. I recently discovered it here downtown, and it was a pleasant surprise. It's a nice little convenience store right here. It's called Bargetown Market. It's got, you know, your necessaries in here, anything that you may need. If you don't want to go all the way to the store, you can just come right in there and pick it up. Bargetown Market. Now this building right up here is currently the tallest building here in Evansville. It will soon be, unfortunately, demolished. They will be starting a new complex project here that I believe is going to include shops, restaurants, and possibly more apartments. So this will no longer be standing here within the next few years. Now if you're planning on living here in downtown Evansville like I do, you're going to need, you know, your share of doctors, you know, essential things to, you know, help take care of yourself. One place right here that I go to is Main Street Family Dental. This is my dentist office. It's right here on Main Street. It's about a 5-minute or so walk from my apartment, so it's very convenient. There's also different hospitals and different doctor's offices down here in downtown. It's where you can get a primary doctor, or, you know, whatever, your family doctor, whatever you may need. You have different options down here in Evansville. Part of downtown that I'm in right now, you can pretty much call our events district. This building behind me is the Victory Theater. It is where you can go see live concerts and different events there. I haven't been there in so long, probably since elementary school for a field trip or something. But yeah, great place to have a night out, see live concerts, you know, that sort of thing. Right here behind me, we have our state-of-the-art arena here in downtown Evansville, the Ford Center. It is a multi-purpose facility, hosts concerts, basketball games, hockey games. It's home to the University of Evansville Purple Aces, and we also have a professional hockey team here called the Evansville Thunderbolts. Like I said, concerts also are able to be seen here. We have different artists that come through here all the time. So again, just like the Victory Theater, this is also a fun place to come to if you're wanting to get out for a night and see an event or something. All right, and here behind me we have the Old National Events Plaza. If events are maybe too small to be in the Ford Center, or you know, if a convention is in town or something, they'll usually go here. This is pretty much a convention center for us. Again, it's the Old National Events Plaza. We typically have different concerts here, different conventions, different seminars, you know, whatever it may be. They usually take place here. And it is right across from the Ford Center. You're into reading or going to the library, right behind me we have the Evansville Central Library here in downtown. It is diagonal from the Ford Center, next to the Old National Events Plaza, and it is right across the street from the Doubletree Hotel. Right here behind me we have the fairly new medical school here in downtown Evansville. If you have students that go to USI, UV, and they're in the medical programs there, I believe they have opportunities to be able to train and study here at this new medical school here downtown. So it's definitely a great resource for those students to take advantage of here. As I mentioned earlier, if you're looking for any doctors, here is one of our clinics here downtown. It is a Deaconess clinic. There is some doctors here, different varieties and different types. So if you're living down here downtown, you don't have to go far to find a new doctor. you guys are looking for a good barber here in downtown Evansville, check out InterPro Barbers. It's where I go. Nolan cuts my hair. Pretty excellent barbershop here in downtown Evansville. One of my favorite restaurants here in downtown Evansville is Brewburger. Brewburger is a well-known burger joint in the Midwest area. I believe they are throughout Indiana, Ohio, Kentucky, maybe Illinois. Not 100% sure. It's some of those states though, but Brewburger is here in Evansville and is a very popular restaurant here in downtown. Used to be a Greyhound station as well. As you can see, it's a pretty cool looking building, and the inside is even cooler. They have some really cool interior in there, and makes for a great experience. As you journey through downtown Evansville, you'll begin to notice that there's a lot of history here in the city. Behind me, we have our classic courthouse here in downtown. The courthouse surprisingly hosts a lot of different activities and stuff. I know around Halloween time they turn the basement into a haunted house, so there's definitely some interesting things that happen inside of there. But yeah, this is our courthouse here in downtown. Here behind me, we have one of Evansville's newest apartment complexes. It is called Post House. If you're more for the modern city type living for apartments, this would be the option for you. Post House presents a lot of different modern floor plans for their apartments. They have a lot of amenities, including a pool, an outdoor theater, and a dog park, I believe. And so, yeah, if you enjoy all that stuff, Post House would be for you. If you're new to Evansville and you're wondering who you're going to pay your utilities to, this company right here, which apparently is called CenterPoint Energy now, is the company you will usually pay your utilities through. They formerly were known as Vectren, but apparently they've been bought out and have had a name change by CenterPoint Energy. So that's something. So this property behind me is Tropicana Evansville. This is where I actually happen to work at. Tropicana Evansville is a resort that possesses a gaming casino, and it also offers two hotels. One would be Tropicana right here, and the other hotel is the Boutique Hotel, which is further down, called Lamerigo. Tropicana also offers several different restaurants, whether it be sit down or quick grab and go restaurants. There's also many different banquet rooms, different conference center rooms here. Just a wide variety of things to do here. It is very popular for people around the tri-state area to come here and stay and gamble. And, you know, it's another thing here in Evansville to have a fun night out at. So I know we'd definitely be happy to have your business here at Tropicana. Thank you. behind me here, we have the USS LST 325 Museum. This consists a museum that shows you the history of the LST 325, which was a warship. It actually used to be docked further down the Ohio River, and they recently, within the last year, just moved it down closer to the Tropicana property. It is actually where Tropicana used to be located. Tropicana used to be located on a riverboat that would go out and sail on the Ohio River. And probably about 3 years ago, Tropicana moved over to land across the street. And now, right there, if you can see it behind me, is where the LST is located now. And that is where Tropicana used to be on their boat. I believe Tropicana's boat is now down in New Orleans. It is a river jazz cruise boat, if I'm not mistaken. So, yep, that is the LST 325. All right, guys, well, that's gonna be about it for today. I know I didn't show you guys entirely everything that's down here, downtown Evansville, but I got to show you guys, you know, some of my favorite things and, you know, things that make downtown fun and, you know, a great place to live. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.